International business. In our global economy, it represents a huge series of opportunities, but also irritations and frustrations. Ask Li Bai. 600 shipments from her Chinese webshop arrived at a European airport today. This afternoon, 560 of them will be on their way again by road or rail to their final destinations. 40 won't. Why? She has no idea. Or talk to Jan van Basten. Last month, his container full of avocados left Veracruz in Mexico cooled to 4 degrees and at a humidity of 90%. Today, it arrived in Rotterdam again at 4 degrees and 90% humidity. But what happened to the container in between, on dockside, aboard ship, during the crane driver's lunch break when left unattended? He has no idea. Meanwhile, the medical equipment Leo Muller has dispatched from Eindhoven to a hospital in Nashville has been held up in a South Carolina port for days, and there it will remain until the discrepancies between three sets of documents are resolved. But if we adopt the concept of smart and secure trade lanes, they become problems of the past. So when specialists from business, government, and universities get together with all parties involved in physical transportation processes, you can be sure some valuable insights will emerge. Working in unison, they addressed the creation of a new logistics concept, using state-of-the-art IT technology and blockchain techniques, and utilizing a port community system and all kinds of other clever communication tools. Why? Simply to bring together all information concerning shipments in a single network of trusted networks. A systematic approach that starts with a simple order or invoice and gets consistently enriched with data from waybills, checkpoints, shipping notices, container sensors, track and trace systems, and inspection reports as goods move from A to B. The result is an information source that can be accessed by all parties according to their needs and their authorization levels, possibly seeking additional information. Everyone with a legitimate interest in the shipment and with the corresponding authorization. We call it the Internet of Logistics. It's precisely what Li Wai wants to keep track of her parcels and to trace their whereabouts 24/7. It's exactly what Jan van Basten needs to keep his cool while moving his avocados from one climate to another. And it's a shot in the arm for Leo Muller, who believes medical equipment should be put to work in hospitals instead of hanging around in harbors. And in a similar way, it can give your business the boost it deserves.